This is a great place to be. This is the mile 17.5 trestle on the E&N Railway's Port Alberni subdivision, roughly above Cathedral Grove Park. And I'm taking a break here, and I love it here. The creek is just behind me, and I love the sound of that. I hope you're having a great day, and I hope you enjoy this video.
Here's the big picture map. Vancouver Island on the west coast of British Columbia. Red circle is roughly the area where I'm hiking. Here's a mid-range map with Cameron Lake in the middle. And my hike is the west end of Cameron Lake and a little bit westward from there. Here's a closer view map with Cameron Lake. And my hike starts near the bottom at that red X, approximate mile 20.6. My turnaround is approximate mile 16.6 or 16.7, right at the west end of Cameron Lake. And the four little purple bits there are the four trestles that I encounter, their approximate locations. And here I am at the trestle. It's the fourth time I've been here within a year, so I'll do what I always do. Cross over and then stop, and I'll look for a photograph looking up towards Mount Arrowsmith. And there's Mount Arrowsmith. Looking back Railway West, I'm making a photograph. It takes a while in this kind of low light, even at a high ISO. We'll see how it turns out. First milepost of the day, number 20. Keep on going. And I'm coming up to the Arrowsmith Water Tower site. Also coming up to a lovely spider web right there. Mile 19.6. I'm curious on the growth of all the weeds around here. I'll get a better view on my way back in full daylight. There's Scott's sign, along with the Leonard Frank photo from 1911 of the first train on its way back from Port Alberni. Yeah, here's all the weeds. Last February, there's some brushing work done by a contractor in this area. And so that cut this all down. And this is an example of one season's worth of growth. These next scenes have some interesting color to them. A lot of orange and red hues. And partly caused by the camera, with my white balance reacting to the lighting conditions just immediately before sunrise, and partly because there was a lot of browns, oranges, and reds in the scenes, and caused by a few things. One, by the drought that we've just had in summer 2021, very severe, and so a lot of the grasses and mosses are a dark dead color, and there's even dead patches on the trees themselves in a few spots that I've noticed. But most noticeably, there are lots of red branches lying alongside the grade, and those were branches cut off the trees during the brushing project in January-February 2021, and the dead branches are now a deep red color for the needles of the trees. Don't need my headlamp anymore this morning. Sky is nicely brightening up. I'm about 15 minutes away from sunrise. It'll take a while for the sun to climb up over the mountains if we're going to get some direct sunlight. I think it's supposed to cloud over shortly after. We'll see what happens. As usual, my goal is to get to the fourth trestle, my favorite one,
while the morning light is still favorable. So we will see if that happens. In the meantime, everything's kind of got a sepia look to it right now. This is the sixth time that I've done this hike, and the third time that it's been done since the brushing work was done, where I've got good sight lines and I'm not dodging broom plants right now. The objectives, I want to see how the railway is holding up here and the structures, the four trestles. This one is a hard area to get to, involves a lot of hiking, and so I'm kind of my own self-appointed, not caretaker, but I want to make sure I'm keep aware of any rock slides or windfalls or just deterioration. The other objective, to enjoy a lovely morning hike. I haven't had one of these for a couple months. The heat waves of the summer and the drought really impacted my ability to enjoy and go out. Kind of became a heat and drought recluse. But we're supposed to get some rain later on this week, so that makes my soul happy. So this has become one of my favorite hikes. Easy for me to get to as far as driving, 45-minute drive from my home, 4 miles out, 4 miles back. Interesting variety of things. Nice light, like right here. And, yeah, just easy to go. 12 or 13 kilometers it works out to be returned, so that's a really good workout. Grades aren't too bad, although there's some 2.1 and 2.2% right at the very end for me on my return leg. That's always fun, but that's okay. Here's an area around mile 19.2 or so where the grade accumulates some water when it's wet. So there's a lot of foliage growth. And here comes mile 19. The post is up on the right-hand side here. I'm getting close to the next structure, compound bridge. Looking forward to that one again. I'm coming up to one of my favorite rock faces on this hike, about mile 18.9. It's just coming up ahead. There's a nicer view just in the corner. Okay, let's head to the compound bridge. Light is really nice now. I'm enjoying this. I'm around mile 18.2, just noting in the grade, again, the growth that's happened after just, you know, one season of growth. No broom problems yet, but things like those little maple tree saplings in the middle of the grade, other weeds really close, give those things another couple years of growth and they're a problem again. So, that's my motivation to keep doing these walks now, to enjoy them while they're easy to walk. And who knows, when it gets overgrown again, maybe by then I'll have lost interest and I'll just be happy to have this legacy of when the sight lines were somewhat clear again. Time will tell. Here comes the mile 18.1 trestle. This one is in poor shape. The deck was in really poor shape, and when there was the brushing work done in February, the contractors installed some planks on top of the deck just to make it safer to walk on. I kind of liked the sketchiness of it beforehand, but here it is. Again, the foliage is starting to creep through on either side, and I'll show you a couple of old views of the trestle from this angle here, looking east on my previous visits when it was horrible.
Okay, time to do some double camera video and walk across and back. This always causes me more edit work, but I like the result. Yeah, it's really sketchy down here. Yeah, that's the worst part. So let's avoid it. Yeah, really soft right there. Continue eastward. One more trestle, the one that I think is my favorite. Seems that whatever hike I'm on, one of those trestles is my favorite. Maybe just for a short time in 2021, the sign was nice and easily visible. There it is. And the trestle. All right, let's continue. Here's another example of some of the growth that's happened in the last growing season, which it was a few months ago, and they continue to grow. And there's more ferns here. Here's a recent windfall from the past few months. This is the kind of thing I'm interested in noting. How frequent these are, and also more importantly, if there's any more rocks, big rocks that have come down. Here's the flanger sign. All right, here's the mile 17.5 trestle, my favorite of the four. Happy to see it again. I like this one. It's nice curve in the woods. Trees that are lit up behind are going to have beautiful colored leaves in, I don't know, about 6 weeks from now. I like this. This isn't an Instagram-y place. It's fairly quiet, not disturbed by people. And yeah, it's a good place. Good place for me to stop and enjoy life for a while. And there's a creek, which gives really nice sound. This is the whole deal. I love it. Okay, let's do some double camera work again here. I made one of my favorite trestle photos from this spot right here in October of 2019. Nice.
Here's another area of ferns that are overgrowing the grade, along with some broom coming in from the other side. So this will be our next issue. This is the section of broken track. Three areas that were broken sometime in 2020. It's the second area of brokenness. And the third one is the worst. I always like showing this one. Yeah, nice clean break. Everything was pushed down. And there's the reason, the giant boulder right there. So one of my objectives again for today's hike is to see if there's any other new situations like that that have happened in the last few months. This is an area of the E&N that doesn't really have a roadmaster that knows the condition, the current condition. And that's simply because while this is active in the legal sense, there's been no train activity here for almost 20 years. I've got the lake to the right showing us a nice glistening sunlit bit of white there. Looking straight ahead, broom in the middle of the grade, and this is the extent of the brushing project from February 2021. It stopped here. I thought it was going to continue. I was hoping it would, but obviously it hasn't. And again, there's the sign of how far they went. And just up here around the corner is where I like to do my little turnaround, because there's some nice rocks to lean up against and take a bit of a break. A view, peekaboo view of the lake. This is about mile 16.7 or so. I'd go further, but the broom's awful, and I only want to do that after there's been a frost for the ticks to kill those. So if I come from the other end later on in October, I'll push on to here, or if I come down here again, I'll push on to mile 16. Mile 16 is kind of my spot where I meet from both ends to do this complete segment in a couple different hikes. That's what I'd like to do, so that I can be aware of how things are here in the back corner of the lake. So far, no change here up to about mile 16.7, but between mile 14.6 and here, there could have been changes. There's lots of rock fall areas. I'll find that out maybe next month. Okay, this is a nice place to take a break. Sit my butt down on a rock there. And now let's head back on my inbound leg of my hike. About 2 miles. No, 4 miles. So that's about 2 hours of walking on railway with a few more stops. I think when I get to the next trestle, I'm gonna stop and enjoy it for a while. Just sit down and listen to the creek, drink some coffee, and know that life is good. I'd like to give a shout out to all the animals who are watching me hike, all the cougars who are looking at this funny looking human packing a camera, three cameras, and talking to himself. Yeah, I've seen a squirrel, I've seen bear poop and deer poop, and I've heard woodpeckers. That's all I've got, and I've got some evidence of humans, a few broken bottles even out here, really. But yeah, well, the only thing I know for sure is cougars enjoy watching me. Not that I'm special. They enjoy watching lots of people. So, lining the sides of the railway here are broom plants. And this is mainly the growth for the year. If they were cut down in the brushing work, or this guy was a little bit cut down, but not much, making its return. So the broom's coming back. Again, we'll see if it takes another year or two and it'll be difficult to walk here again. And I'm back at mile 17.5 trestle. Good place to rest for half an hour or so. I'm going to enjoy this. Sharp smell of creosote. Intoxicating. These are my useful props. The rail link water thermos. I've got coffee in it. Keeps it nice and warm. And the hat. Hey, that works. Keeps the sun off my head when the sun is shining or if the rain is happening. This is a lovely space to take a rest here at the mile 17.5 trestle. All right, this is a good spot to have a nice break at. That's what having a nice, slow, relaxing life is about. All right, bye-bye. Here's a spot around mile 18.5 or so. There's a old trail, old path going down and going up the slope. That's had me curious. So I think today I'm gonna just go up a little ways and try to get a sense of whether it's just a hiking trail or more a bike trail or whether there's a bit more history to it. We'll find out, maybe. Okay, so here's the path above the railway. Interesting. Wonder if this connects to up behind Loon Lake and Summit Lake. Let's go back down to the railway. All right, mile 18. Time to cross another trestle. Kind of looks funny with the planking. But when it's a job site, like it was back in February, it needs to be up to certain safety standards, I guess. Simple little trestle, and probably the one that's in the worst shape in the entire E&N system. And I'm approaching the mile 18.8 compound bridge. Again, the trees, the leaves are going to be lovely in about 6 weeks. I don't know if I'll be back for that, we'll see. Lots of autumn leaves opportunities on the E&N, so I'm not sure where I'll go if the weather and schedules cooperate. We'll see. But here I am here now, and I'm tired. I'm out of shape from doing railway walking. Haven't done it for a while, so I'm huffing and puffing, going slow. but I'll make it. Back to mile 19. Here's the Aerosmith Water Tower site, mile 19.6. With all the growth here. And up ahead on the left around the corner is the site where the section house was. Here's Buddy. He is busy. Section house was right through there, the clearing, and behind, maybe probably outhouses and stuff. I heard that there was a parking garage or a carport or something like that on the highway down below the section house, down far below the slope, and that's where the worker would park, go up the steep trail to the section house and water tower for work. Thanks to Ken for that information. I'm getting closer to being done. The mile 20.2 trestle. It's always the first one I see and the last one I see on these out and back hikes in this area. And there's a really long curve now, going up the 2.1% grade, and then the last bit for my hike will be a 2.2%, and then I'm back to where I started. And this is what it's like right here on mile 20.6. Broken bottles, junk, more broken bottles. There's junk. Thankfully, this is the only place where I've seen this kind of junk along this part of the railway.